How's it going, everyone? It is Andre Williams, and over here we talk stocks and we focus on one thing. Always protect your profits. And today we're going to be talking about Clove that ended up having a strong move inside of the market today. Of course, we took some profits. I don't know if you did so yourself, but I still have some shares that I'm still holding on to. But I won't waste any more time and let's jump into the agenda. If you're new to this channel, I just want to let you know we have timestamps down below inside the description. But if you are a shareholder or you're thinking about taking a position, I highly suggest you watch this full entire video. So the first thing we're going to be going over is a technical analysis. We're going to be taking a look at support, we're going to be taking a look at resistance, and where do we want to see Clove going into tomorrow. And then afterwards, we're going to be going on Fintel, taking a look at the overall short interest information. Does it still continue to have short squeeze potential? We're going to find out. And then we're going to be taking a look at the order flow distribution. Were institutions loading up on shares? We want to know, because this does have an impact on the overall stock price. And then when all of that is done, we'll be going into the final thoughts and as well as some more key details. So we're going to be doing a technical analysis for Clove. Let's see how it performed on the day. So ended up closing at $8.73, being down 2.13%. On the low, it tested $8.55, and then on the high, testing $9.11. When we take a look at the volume stats on the day, you can see we traded at 26.512 million shares, and the average volume over 10 trading days being at 37.048 million shares. So we did have some below average volume on the day, and we ended up seeing some pressure on the stock price. Now the chart we're using is a 1 year daily chart. When we take a look at our RSI down below, you can see it's right around 52.55, and when we take a look at the moving averages on the chart, we are below the 200 day, the 100 day, and we continue to have momentum above the 21 day EMA, which is set at $8.44. So this is the area of support that you're actually going to want to see Clove hold going into tomorrow. I know it did pull back quite a bit inside of the after hours so far at 4:53 p.m. at the time of this recording, but hey, if it's able to hold this level going into the open and during regular trading hours, then I'm going to be looking forward to seeing a move to the upside. We did see some resistance today at $9.11. A lot of selling ended up happening, but of course that is no surprise due to the volatility that's inside of this stock. So if we end up getting a similar move going into tomorrow, then of course I want to see us being able to actually get to at least testing here at the 100 day around $9.42. If we end up getting to this particular area, of course there will be some resistance, but I feel like we can gain some momentum. Things can really start looking good for Clove here. So let's be patient, see what happens, and yeah, hope you guys found this helpful. So we're going to take a look at the short interest information for Clove. So as we scroll down on the page, the short shares availability is at 100,000, updated 18 hours ago, and for the short borrow free rate, it is at 3.47%. Now when we take a look at the history of the short volume ratio, we can see for the close of the 23rd, it was at 24.81, and then the close for the 24th, which was yesterday, being at 27.94. So seeing these stats and knowing that the short volume ratio has creeped up, Clove still continues to have short squeeze potential. So that's just one thing to keep in mind, but do know, since this does impact the overall market sentiment for the stock, this comes with a lot of volatility. So I just want to make sure you are prepared for that, and if you do have a trading strategy, make sure you follow the right initial setups, because this could be very beneficial if you have a game plan in place to take advantage of the movement that we usually see in Clove. Now let's take a look at the order flow distribution for Clove. So we can see here on the inflow, it was at 48.89, and then on the outflow, it was at 55.89. So on the large, we had 0, on the medium, we had 34.39, and then on the small, we had 14.50. Now on the outflow side, on the large, we had 1.72, and then on the medium, we had 38.75, and then on the small, we had 15.42. When we take a look at the large scale orders in the last 5 days, you can see for August the 25th, we ended up having an outflow day being at 1,718.64. We did have an inflow day on the 24th, which we covered, which was at 836. 7. So what does this tell us? There was a lot of profit taking today, and this happened on both sides, not only with retail investors and traders, but as well as for institutions. But one thing that we do know for a fact, and we talked about inside of the technicals, as long as it's able to hold areas of support, things continue to look good going into tomorrow. But of course, let's jump into the final thoughts and we'll go over some more details. So for my final thoughts for CLOVE, the area that we want to see hold up, especially going into the open, is around $8.44. If this area can hold, then we can look forward to seeing another strong run up. But do keep in mind, this is going to be dependent on a lot of buying volume coming through this stock. I know it's going to be on a lot of watch lists. Of course, it's on mine, and it's part of the reasons why I like to play it. And it's why the reason why I took some profits today as well. I'm not fully out of my position as of yet, because I really want to see how well it could hold up. And since my cost basis is at $8, that's why I have no problems with being patient to see how far this play can actually make another move like it did today, or maybe even go further. The next thing that I want to go over when we went on Fintel, yes, it continues to have short squeeze potential, which is great because we know already with that buying pressure, this stock can make some very strong moves to the overall upside. But with the volatility that we have with the Fed meeting that's going to be coming up, I know for a fact there's going to be multiple opportunities for traders to take advantage of. And like I said, if you are going to be investing in CLOVE for the long term, because I do believe in the long term prospects as well, then do know, do not be fazed by all of the price action that you are seeing. Again, a lot of traders are taking advantage of these opportunities, especially we see a lot of attention coming across on meme stocks as well. So again, everything that you see happening with this stock, it's just something to just get used to if you're going to be holding it for a while, because you're going to be seeing a lot of volume spikes, especially when it hits certain price levels and so on. So I just wanted to make sure everyone was aware of that and you have a clear strategy of what your goals are if you are inside of this play. So I hope you enjoyed this video and we'll be talking real soon. We'll be right back.